Well, I'll put it this way, Colonel. If you were going to think of mixed martial arts as a pantheon, Fedor would unquestionably be Zeus. 25 times the best heavyweights in the world have stepped up and taken a shot at the champ, and 25 times they were dispatched in the signature brutal Fedor style. It says it all that in a sport with multiple major organizations, nobody questions the fact that this guy is the king of the hill.
Lana could not agree more. Several weeks ago, 16 fighters stepped into a Costa Rican crucible and 8 emerged as the newly forged Team USA. But there's no time to celebrate, because tonight they square off against the most vicious MMA team in Eastern Europe, the Russian Red Devils. Going back to the days of the old Soviet Union, Russian athletes have had a saying, winning is our bread and meat. If we don't win, we don't eat. And you're going to see exactly that kind of hunger displayed tonight as the Red Devils look to make an impact in the Bodog ring that's commensurate with the one that they've already made in their homeland.
What style of fighting can we see from men who are both approaching 300 pounds?
Brawling. To my personal taste, I love that kind of fight. I'm a brawler myself, and we're going to see it taken to the nth level when we see Junior Silva up against Eric Pele. Silva, a knockout artist, 9-0, none of his fights going past the end of the first round. Eric Pele, a Samoan fighter. Samoans being known for incredible knockout resistance. So I want to see what transpires when the irresistible force of Silva collides with the immovable object of Pele.
Covering up, can he fight out of it? Oh, yes, he can!
Big right hand from Pele drops Silva to the canvas.
Can Pele do?
I think neither man should be comfortable with leaving this in the hands of the judges. This has been a back and forth war. And now Khabib once again in the side mount position, throwing knees into the liver area of Fritz the Animal Paul. The crowd electric with every impact, roaring, cheering on Nabil the Thrill in his quest to become the Canadian middleweight champion.
Unbelievable! As I said at the very beginning of the fight, Zenit standing outside very patiently waiting for the opportunity to strike like a cobra. And when he got it, he exploited that opportunity viciously. Aguilar still reeling from the results of that bombardment of punishment.
Tried to beat Prangley to the draw.
Prangley now hanging on to a Greco-Roman clinch, perhaps trying to slow the action down a little bit. I mean, it's understandable. Semenov's fists were like a swarm of bees. Those are properly thrown tie kicks. Aguilar's getting his shin across the thigh. He's hitting with a bent leg and then pushing into the leg. That puts the force deeper in, so you almost touch bone. And Zenon's got to be feeling it already. That's going to be knotting up as the fight wears on.
You're hitting it, Paul. You know that better than anyone else.
Absolutely. I'm a Vancouver resident myself, and I got to say that we've had almost an embarrassment of riches lately. This year alone, first Elite Fighting Championships brings us Bodog, and now Bodog has brought us the world.
Fight is right back up on the feet where Fritz Paul has had the better of it for most of this fight. But Khabib still applying that pressure. This man is a juggernaut. He does not know the meaning of the words back up. And again, looking to trap Fritz Paul into a corner, perhaps put this fight away and take it out of the hands of the judges. Time now for Cobra Energy Drink's Power Shot of the Night. Oh! A thunderous shot to the face! And it is over! Rory McDonald's debut spoiled by Team Bushido. Cedric Grenot with an explosive shot! This one is over! What an unexpected finish to tonight's main event as Mark Bocek marches in here and taps out master grappler Kevin the Mongoose Manderson.
Well, who would have thunk it with Bocek fighting a guy with 20 fights and coming out there and dominating Kevin the Mongoose Manderson? A spectacular showing by Mark Bocek.
You could tell that he was physically a lot stronger and he was a dominant man straight through, and it was no surprise to me. He looked like he could manhandle him all day long.
So that's all we got for you tonight, folks. I'm Paul the Mauler Lazenby for Glenn the Cokester Coca and Showdown Joe Ferraro. We will see you for the next installment of Hardcore Championship Fighting on The Score, home for the hardcore. Hardcore Championship Fighting is brought to you by Cobra Energy Drink. Feel the bite.
It's over! Unbelievable! This has to be the most colossal upset in super heavyweight MMA history!